all's well, I hope. Aside from the obvious. waiting for you in Baldur's Gate, Astarion. A sweetheart, perhaps?
Not one in particular. The city is a veritable feast of sweethearts.
You must be eager to get back, then. Slimmer pickings out in this wilderness.
Let's crack it open.
The book is locked tight with no visible keyhole, only an oval recess in the cover's mouth. You try to examine the book, but the longer you stare, the more those piercing amethyst eyes draw you in. You feel the darkness radiating from the book. It's delicious.
Book. How obvious. Whoever opens it deserves the fate that befalls them.
Curious. Why don't you take a closer look? I'll observe from back here.
What now? A young cave bear, killed and stuffed before its teeth were fully grown. Might be useful. Empty.
Shadow. Such a grim name for such a
mumbling that line to yourself earlier. It needs more work.
Fortunate for his tongue, he didn't say it to me.
what's hiding here.
From an overgrowth of moss, the well looks unremarkable. Dry stones line the wall. At the bottom, something gleams in the dappled light.
Those webs, or I'll end up as a meal.
Haste. Shouldn't have made me your enemy. Thank you.
I wasn't expecting it.
I've known people who are hungry for power, but Gale takes it a bit too literally for my liking. I wonder how he does it. Why he does it. I'm sure all will be revealed in time, but I don't like it. A waste of perfectly good treasure.
How can I help?
Someone there?
Let's get going.
Gale is positively voracious. Well, let him suck up all the magic he needs, as long as he doesn't snack on a Githyanki silver sword. Entirely. I was as devoted to my studies as I was to my training. Each creche contains a Zathisk purification device. So I learned from the writings in the Kalir Library. The library was a gift from Vlakith herself, that we may gain total understanding. Countless scholars roam the astral sea and beyond, observing the ways of our lessers, exploring planes so distant order turns to chaos and cold fires rage. The planes are ever quaking and their peoples ever shifting. The Githyanki possess an eternity of knowledge. Yet we still collect more. Infinities upon infinities. I expect I am your first. Of course you haven't. They would have cut you from navel to neck. You are no less alien to me than I am to you. I know of your kind, but I do not often encounter them. That large, fleshy nose of yours looks like a mistake. Decadent, then. Lacking in economy. Like so much of this world and its undisciplined people. I understand much beyond your comprehension. More to the point, I know the cure for our condition. It is imperative we locate a creche. You do well to observe more and question less.